who is the most intelligent person? In my opinion, the intelligent person can be judged not by his answers, but by his questions. That is very, very important. So that's what I think people who, in any classroom or in any session, the one who keeps on asking questions is considered to be the most most useful person for the society. But mind you, there are some people who know the answers, but they keep asking questions, they are not good. They know the answers, but still they keep on asking questions, they are not. Many times when I have gone for seminar and gone for some international, national conference, there are some habitual question asking people are there. So many times you ask them, you know the answer, please tell the answer. So actually, anyway, this we are amidst, we are deep into the political campaigning, and country is facing the 18th Lok Sabha election. I am contesting from Bangalore Rural Constituency on BJP ticket. It's basically in this state, at this point of time, BJP and JDS are in alliance. As an NDA candidate, I am contesting from Bharatiya Janata Party. In fact, I request every one of you to vote for BJP, because the election is falling on April 26th, Friday. The mindset of our people is the weekend starts from Friday. For some people, Thursday evening only weekend starts. So at least for the sake of democracy, for the sake, spend this April 26th weekend. Keep this, because as cardiologist, as a director of Jayadev Institute of Cardiovascular Sciences, I was also working almost 16 hours, 17 hours physically. Mentally, we were working 24 hours. So, if somebody asked me, the most enjoyable day in your life is staying at home. Staying at home is the most enjoyable day whenever this thing. So, keep this April 25th, because we know that you have all decided to vote for Narendra Modi ji, and this country needs an assertive leader and also needs a stable government. You look at some of the already Chakravarti, as he was listing what are all the achievements he has done. Virtually he has turned around the face of administrative structure, administrative model and decision making model in this country in the last 10 years. For example, foreign investment in infrastructure is allowed up to 49%. See, today, you look at express highways, look at railway facilities, Vande Bharat and similar this thing, and look at the defense initiatives. Foreign investment has been allowed up to 49% in roads, express highways. Foreign investment has been allowed even in railways, and foreign investment is allowed in defense, because defense is one area we are scared. How can we allow foreign investment? Because are we exposing our own country's risk there? But technology, normally production of vaccine takes about 10 years normally. But we have got a fantastic genetic platform, and as a result, vaccine could be produced within 11 months. And India, among all the countries, including America, France, Japan, China, Russia. In fact, WHO said India managed COVID better than any nation in this world. India has managed COVID better than anything. And 200 crore vaccine doses were given for people above 18 years of age. Had it not been given, in fact, there was a political thing in the United States. There were waves after waves, fourth wave, fifth wave, sixth wave, because it took a political turn. Republicans said, we'll not take vaccine. Then Democrats said, we will take vaccine. But unfortunately, here, India, those things did not happen. Although initially there were some hiccups, but it did not happen. Had it not been given, probably, I don't know, how many would have been missing from that side or this side, I don't know, in this. So that is the greatest contribution. And look at today, heart attack is no more a disease of elite class, no more a disease of urbanites. It is equally prevalent among poor people, villagers, laborers, and 35% of heart attack in India is today below 40 years of age. And normally we treat the blockages with stents, insert a stent through angiogram technique. The cost of this stent, initially it was 1 lakh per each stent, then it came down to 70. Thanks to Narendra Modi at that time, our Anand Kumar ji was the minister for chemicals, fertilizers and urban infrastructure. The cost of the stent in 2015 was reduced from 70,000 to 25,000. Today, that is one of the greatest contributions. I think this is where a technology, is giving importance to all sectors. For example, how many medical colleges? Nearly 350 medical colleges have been added in the last 10 years. And regarding IITs, IIMs, all those things, anyway, it is always there. Of course, as an youngster, it is not the quantity of the professionals coming out from various institutions, not the quantity that matters, it's the quality. We should always talk about quality products. But only another area of concern, that's today, India has taken a little backseat in terms of research. It's only about 2% of GDP spent on research. This is one area we have to improve upon, because countries like Japan, China, United States, they are spending 6% of GDP on our research, because without research, there cannot be a progress, there cannot be a newer thoughts. So this is where a country has to move forward. And another interesting thing, India is close to developing your cryogenic engines and also semiconductors. See, when once we develop that thing, India will be on top of the world. India will be on top of this world. And all today, I think this is what COVID has given us lesson. See, when some things are easily available, we will not look into all those things. Now all those things are blocked and India is looking. Because talent pool in India, we have a great talent pool and we have to provide a very good platform and opportunity to enter politics. What happened, I retired on January 31st this year. Then post retirement, there were a lot of felicitations and celebrations, both in Bangalore, in different parts of Bangalore, then in Assam, then in Mysore, in Kalburgi and all. So a lot of people from other states also were calling me, Dr. Manjunath, you are not just a cardiologist, you brought some reforms in a public health sector. So your reforms and should not be restricted to your own state. It is better you should do something. I think you need a little bigger stage and bigger platform so that country may be benefited. Then they were also telling Honorable Prime Minister is giving a lot of importance to achievers and those game changers. And so probably this is how it all started. Then my name got floated. So with lot of thinking, and I took some time, and then I decided to enter this politics. That is one question. And I think why I chose BJP, that was basically decision of the high command. So in fact, BJP and JDS, they are in alliance in the state. So choosing the constituency, choosing the party, was the decision of the high command. And certainly, because he is giving a lot of importance to, in the cabinet itself. That means some experts' opinions are valued, and they are given some respect. He is at crossroads, to be frank. Political system is at crossroads. And so it should come, because it is like a cobweb system. It's a cobweb system. So you should always have an open mind. And youngsters, yes. But one thing is, your mind should not be polluted. It should not be polluted. And definitely, sometimes it so happens, no, politics is not my cake, because it's all spoiled and all. So keeping away from, if good people, efficient people, those who are service-oriented people, if they are keeping away from them, then probably it can get still worse. So there can be always an exception. Even in present, any political party for that matter, there are some exceptions, 5 to 10% exceptions are there. But your work will be recognized by the society. So your work will be, so youngs, I'm, of course, one should study well. So you should not drop out, for the sake of politics, youngsters should not drop out from your education system. So for the sake of politics, get well educated, get well knowledgeable. Most important, try to achieve this thing, whether it is politics or this thing, go step by step. Don't, have too many ambitions in your mind, because there is no escalator for success actually. You have to go step by step and keep your ambitions within limits. You should not have opportunistic mind. And you should have some goals in your mind. So if an opportunity is given, what best I can do? So with that sort of a mindset, I can do. Certainly, youngster's role is very, very important. But most important, now the present trend is they try to achieve too many things in a short time, get into problem. That is the reason today, because of stress, so many, I think,
ಅದುಬಿಡೀಗ ಮ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಇವಾಗ ನೋಡಿ, ಮನೆ ಮನೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕಲರ್ ಕರ್ಟನ್, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸೋಫಾ ಕಲರ್, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಫ್ಲೋರ್ ಎಲ್ಲವೂ ಮ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೈಫ್. ಆಯ್ತು, ನೀವು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಬರೀ ಮಾತಿನಮಲ್ಲ, ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಬೆಪ್ಪ ಬಾಯಿ ಬಿಡೋಕೆ ಬರಲ್ಲ. ನೀವು ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟು ದುಡ್ಡು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಕಳ್ಳ ಹೇಗೆ ದುಡ್ಡು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, ನೀವು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಕ್ಕ ದುಡಿಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ದಾರ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಶೋ ಮಾಡದಿದ್ರೆ ಇವಾಗ ಮಾಕಂಜು, ನೀವು ಸತ್ತೋದ್ರೆ ಪಾಪ ಸಾಯಬಾರ್ದು, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಸಾಯದೆ ಉಳಿದ್ರೆ ಲೋಕರ್ ಸಾಯಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಉತ್ತರ ಒಂದೇ, ನಾವು ಮನುಷ್ಯರನ್ನು ಮೆಚ್ಚಿಸುವ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡುದು ಬೇಡ, ಭಗವಂತ ಮೆಚ್ಚುವ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡೋಣ.
ಕ್ಯಾಂಪೇನಿಗೆ ವೋಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಮೊದಲ ಬಾರಿ ವೋಟ್ ಮಾಡೋರಿಗೆ, ಯಂಗ್ಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಇವ್ರ ಮುಖಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ವೋಟ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರದು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸಿದ್ರೆ ಆಚೆಗೆ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಹೀಗಾಗಿ ವೋಟರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಬೈಯೋದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗಂತೂ ಬಹಳ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಅರ್ಥ ಕಾಣೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ನನ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನ ವಿಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಹಳ ಬೇಜಾರಿದೆ, 50% ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ದಾಟದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದಕ್ಕೂ ಬಹಳ ರೀಸನ್ಗಳಿರ್ಬೋದು. ಬಟ್ ನನಗನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿಡೇಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಜನ ಬೀದಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ವೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಲೈನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಈ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿಡೇಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಗೆಲ್ಲಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೇಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹಠ ಹಿಡಿದು ವೋಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದನ್ನ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಮೀ, ಈ ಬಾರಿ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲಿ ವೋಟಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗೋದನ್ನ ನೀವೇ ನೋಡ್ತೀರಾ. ಯಾಕೆಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿಡೇಟ್ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ. ಹೀಗಾಗಿ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಬರೀ ಬ್ಲೇಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಕುತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ವೋಟರ್ಸ್ನ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವೋಟರ್ಸು, ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್ ವೋಟರ್ಸು, ಯಾಕೆ ವೋಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗೆ ಉತ್ತರ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರು ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ವೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ.
ರೂರಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್, because that's how we are interacting. We have conducted many camps and we have been interacting with the rural people. See, today the healthcare, 30% of the healthcare is provided by the government, 70% is by the private sector even today. So one of the problem that government sector is facing is, yes, they have plenty of medical colleges, they have plenty of hospitals. The real problem is we have to strengthen the existing hospitals with more manpower. That is where the problem is. We should have more doctors, nurses, technicians, and uninterrupted supply chain of medicines. That is where. So our concept should move from, because only people are, they are going on construction. The focus should change from construction to creation of posts. This is where the problem is. They spend 500 crores and build a beautiful hospital, and for the sake of another 75 crores to provide manpower.
1040 hindu makkalu agiddare bharatadalli idu hosa badalavane, and the parents are proud. avaru tam hend makkalu jothe photo hakkoltare, nan magalu bage baala santosha ide anta proud aguvanta vatavaranavannu narendra modi nirmana madidare anta. alli continue ode bandu yake narendra modi ge vote maadbeku ಬೇರೆ ದಾರಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾನು ಅದಷ್ಟು ನೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ, ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ನಿನ್ನೆ ಇಬ್ರು ತಮ್ಮ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟೋ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟೋ ಹೈಲೈಟ್ಸ್ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ಮಹಾಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ನಿಂದ ಪ್ರತಿ ಬಡ ಕುಟುಂಬ ಒಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಅನ್ಕಂಡೀಷನಲಿ 1 ಲಕ್ಷ ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ. ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಹಾಕ್ತಾ ಕೂತಿದ್ದಾಗ ಈ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಒಟ್ಟಾರೆ ಬಿಪಿಎಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗಳು 6.5 ಕೋಟಿ ಇದೆ. 100,000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಒಂದು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟು 6.5 ಕೋಟಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ 6,52,000 ಕೋಟಿ ರೂಪಾಯಿ ತರಬೇಕು. ನಮ್ಮ ಬಜೆಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಾವಿಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ಸಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಕೊಡ್ತಿದೀವಿ ಅಂತ. ಅಂಡ್ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಪೇಯರ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತಿದೀವಿ. ಯಾರ ದುಡ್ಡಿನಿಂದ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದರಿಂದಾನೆ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. 200 ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರು 200 ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಜಾಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬಳಸ್ತಾರೋ ಅವ್ರದನ್ನು ಅವರೇ ಪೇ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಬಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ಟಿಕೆಟ್ ನ ಹೆಣ್ಮಕ್ಳಿಗೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅವಳು ಕಂಡ ಅವ್ರಿಬ್ರದ್ದು ಸೇರಿ ಪೇ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರಿಗೋ ಫ್ರೀ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತಾರು ಕೊಡಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಅಂತ. ಎರಡನೇದು, UCC ಏನ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನ ಅಲೋ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಶರಿಯಾ ಕಾನೂನು ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಬರ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ. Article 370 ಏನ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಜಾರಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ನ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟೋ. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಬಿಲೀವ್ ದಿಸ್? ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ LGBTQ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಗೌರವ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಸೇಮ್ ಸೆಕ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ವ್ಯಾಲಿಡ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಕಾನೂನಿನ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಓಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ. ಇದು ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ನ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟೋ. ನಾನು ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಗಳ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟೋ ಓದ್ತಿದ್ದೆ, ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಗಳು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾವ್ದಾವ್ದು ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಗಳ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಭಾರತಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯೋ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ವಾಪಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ, ಮತ್ತು ಭಾರತದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅನ್ನ ಧ್ವಂಸಗೊಳಿಸ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ.
ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ನೀವು ನಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಕೂಡ ಫೈಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ, ನಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಗೆ ಇಂದೆಂದು ನಾನು ಕೂಡ ಒಬ್ಬ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಯಕರ್ತ ಆಗಿರೋದು ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಜನನ ಹೇಗೆ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ ನಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಗೆ ಅಂತ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಾಲಂಟಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದರ್ ಕಾರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ನಾಮಿನೇಷನ್. ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ದಿ ಟ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈ ಲೈಫ್. ಪೀಪಲ್ ವರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಇನ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ಫುಲಿ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಮೆನಿ ಮನಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿ ನಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ವಾಲಂಟಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದರ್ ಕಾರ್. ಸರ್, ನೀವು ಗೆದ್ದಿದ್ದೆ ಆದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಗ್ರಾಮಾಂತರ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಕ್ಕೆ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಿಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಬೆಂಗ?
ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಕಾವೇರಿ ವಾಟರ್, ಬಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಕಾವೇರಿ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ರೈನ್ಫಾಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೆಫಿಸಿಟ್ ರೈನ್ಫಾಲ್. ಸಿ, ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಟು ಗೋ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ರಿವರ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಸರ್ವೇ, Bangalore during the best of the rainy season receives somewhere around 17 to 18 TMC of rainwater. So we have to create one separate rainwater harvesting authority for Bangalore itself, so that, see, of course buildings and all have a residential rainwater system, harvesting system. You should have, in my opinion, the public water, because what is happening, water that is going in the street gets into the storm water drain and gets mixed. You should have a separate rainwater harvesting, you should be separated from your BBMP, and you should have a separate authority consisting of environmental engineers, water management experts, and that is where we have to save. I think every drop of rainwater has to be saved, so that your water table also comes up. That is another important thing. The second thing is, of course, in general, that is, we have some loopholes in the existing Ayushman Bharat scheme. We have to strengthen the those loopholes in the some new procedures to be added. That is another important area. And a couple of rural districts, they are growing their occupation is sericulture. So we have to see how best we can bring in newer technology to make it more internationally competitive. And another important thing, I think this is where a thought process has to come. Minimum support price has to be given for the civic farmers whenever the price drops. For example, cost of production of 1 kg of cocoon, if it is 400 rupees, cost of production, if the market price is 200, then they have to, I think, they are gone. Only option is suicide. So there has to be a budgetary allocation. You have to keep money reserved in the budget itself for support price of to support the farmers' agriculture. That is one thing. And 13% of deaths in India are due to accidents. All healthy people are dying in road traffic accident. So national highways, you should develop a trauma care center to treat this accident victims in the golden hour. So these are some of the things. And of course, other problem is infrastructure, roads, and those are the other things. But drinking water is a priority. And education, you should develop in such a way I think the mindset of people today in our primary or higher secondary education is, even if they don't have money to eat, they don't want to send them to government school. That trend has come in. That has to be reversed. We have to, there are some very good government schools. We have to create an awareness.
This is fantastic. ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಅನೇಕ ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಲೀಡರ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಭೇಟಿ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಭಗವದ್ಗೀತೆಯನ್ನು ಗಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಅನೇಕ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೋದಾಗ ಆ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಆ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆರತಿ ಮಾಡ್ಪಡ್ತಾ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರು ಹಾಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂಥ ಡ್ರೆಸ್ನಿಂದ ಹಿಡಿದು ಅವ್ರ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಕೂಡ ಜಗತ್ತಿಗೆ ಹೇಗೆ ತನ್ನಂತಾನು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಿದೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಮೇ ಬಿ ನಾನು ಇದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನನಗೆ ಆಶ್ಚರ್ಯ ಅನ್ನಿಸ್ಬೋದು, ತನ್ನಂತಾನು ಹಿಂದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಅನೇಕರು ನಾಚಿಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ಇವತ್ತು ಇಂಗ್ಲೆಂಡಿನ ಪ್ರಧಾನಮಂತ್ರಿ ಕೂಡ ತಾನು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಂದು ಅಂತ ಬಹಳ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯಿಂದ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಹೇಳುವ ಸಾಧ್ಯತೆಗಳು ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ನಾನು ಹಿಂದೂ ಧರ್ಮವನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಪಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಅನೇಕರು ಇವತ್ತು ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಪಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿ ಭಾರತದ ಆ ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ಪರಂಪರೆಯನ್ನ ಎತ್ತಿ ಹಿಡಿದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. G20 ನಡೆದಾಗ G20 ಸಬ್ ಟೈಟಲ್ ಏನಾಗಿತ್ತು, ಕಿಕ್ಕರ್ ಏನಾಗಿತ್ತು, ಕಿಕ್ಕರ್ ಲೈನ್ ಏನಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಸುದೈವ ಕುಟುಂಬಕಂ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ. ಬಹಳ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಚೀನಾ ಅದನ್ನು ವಿರೋಧಿಸಿತ್ತು. ವಿರೋಧ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಸತ್ತೋಗಿರುವ ಭಾಷೆಯೊಂದರ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ತಗೊಳ್ಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ. ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಜಗತ್ತಿಗೆ ಕನ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ವಸುದೈವ ಕುಟುಂಬಕಮ್ಮನಂತ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಲ್ಲದೆ ಜಗತ್ತಿಗೆ ಒಳಿತು ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಭಾರತ ಸಿದ್ಧವಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರು. ನಾವು ಕೋವಿಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನ್ ಕಂಡಿಡಿದ್ವಿ, ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನ್ ಕಂಡಿಡಿದ ನಂತರ ನಮಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಮತ್ತು ಸುಮಾರು 18-20 ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರಗಳಿಗೆ ಉಚಿತವಾಗಿ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನ್ ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಭಾರತದ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಏನಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ತಕ್ಕಂತೆ ಬದುಕುವ ನೀತಿಯನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರಿಂದಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಗ್ಲೋಬಲ್ ಸೌತ್ ನ ಲೀಡರ್ ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ,
ನೀವು ಈ ಕೂಡ ನಮ್ಮ ಚಾನೆಲ್ಗೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಬಟನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಬೆಲ್ ಐಕನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ನಾವು ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ನೋಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ.